Mahyama Nikaya. Middle Length Sayings. Translated by I.B.Horner. sutta-central.net. Samadhitha Sutta. 9 Discourse on Perfect View. Thus have I heard, at one time the Lord was staying near Savatthaya, in the Jita Grove in Anathapan.eka's monastery. There the Venerable Sariputta addressed the monks, saying, "Monks! Your Reverence," these monks answered the Venerable Sariputta in assent. Then the Venerable Sariputta spoke thus, "Your Reverences, it is said, perfect view, perfect view. To what extent indeed, Your Reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, who is come into this true Dhamma? From afar, Your Reverence, would we come into the Venerable Sariputta's presence to learn the meaning of this utterance? It were good if the meaning of this utterance were to be made clear by the Venerable Sariputta himself. The monks, having heard it from the Venerable Sariputta, will bear it in mind. Very well, Your Reverences, listen and attend carefully and I will speak." "Yes, Your Reverence," these monks answered the Venerable Sariputta in assent. The Venerable Sariputta spoke thus, "When a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends unskill and unskill's root, and comprehends skill and skill's root, to this extent, Your Reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? And what, Your Reverences, is unskill? What is unskill's root? What is skill? What is skill's root? Onslaught on creatures, Your Reverences, is unskill, taking what is not given is unskill, sexual misconduct is unskill, lying speech is unskill, slanderous speech is unskill, harsh speech is unskill, gossip is unskill, covetous is unskill, wrath is unskill, wrong view is unskill. This, Your Reverences, is called unskill. And what, Your Reverences, is unskill's root? Greed is unskill's root, hatred is unskill's root, confusion is unskill's root. This, Your Reverences, is called unskill's root. And what, Your Reverences, is skill? Restraint from onslaught on creatures is skill, restraint from taking what is not given is skill, restraint from sexual misconduct is skill, restraint from lying speech is skill, restraint from slanderous speech is skill, restraint from harsh speech is skill, restraint from gossip is skill, non-covetous is skill, non-wrath is skill, perfect view is skill. This, Your Reverences, is called skill. And what, Your Reverences, is skill's root? Non-greed is skill's root, non-hatred is skill's root, non-confusion is skill's root. This, Your Reverences, is called skill's root. When, Your Reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends unskill thus, comprehends unskill's root thus, comprehends skill's root thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, Your Reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? Saying, "Good, Your Reverence," these monks, having rejoiced in what the Venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the Venerable Sariputta a further question, "Might there be, Your Reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the Ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, Your Reverences. When, Your Reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends sustenance and comprehends the uprising of sustenance and comprehends the stopping of sustenance and comprehends the course leading to the stopping of sustenance, to this extent also, Your Reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. And what, your reverences, is sustenance? What is the uprising of sustenance? What is the stopping of sustenance? What is the course leading to the stopping of sustenance? Your reverences, there are these four kinds of sustenance for the stability of creatures who have come to be or for the assistance of those who are seeking to be. What are the four? Material food, coarse or fine, sense, impingement is the second, volition is the third, consciousness is the fourth. From the uprising of craving is the uprising of sustenance, from the stopping of craving is the stopping of sustenance. The course leading to the stopping of sustenance is this ariyan eightfold way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When a disciple of the ariyans comprehends sustenance thus, comprehends the uprising of sustenance thus, comprehends the stopping of sustenance thus, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of sustenance thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the Venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the Venerable Sariputta a further question, might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. There might be, your reverences. When, your reverences, a disciple of the ariyans comprehends anguish, comprehends the uprising of anguish, comprehends the stopping of anguish, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of anguish, to this extent also, your reverences, does a disciple of the ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. And what, your reverences, is anguish? What is the uprising of anguish? What is the stopping of anguish? What is the course leading to the stopping of anguish? Birth is anguish, and old age is anguish, and disease is anguish, and dying is anguish, and grief, lamentation, suffering, tribulation and despair are anguish, and if one does not get what one wants, that too is anguish. In short, the five groups of grasping are anguish. This, your reverences, is called anguish. And what, your reverences, is the uprising of anguish? That craving which is connected with again becoming, accompanied by delight and attachment, finding delight in this and that, namely the craving for sense pleasures, the craving for becoming, the craving for annihilation, this, your reverences, is called the origin of anguish. And what, your reverences, is the stopping of anguish? Whatever is the stopping, with no attachment remaining, of that self-same craving, the giving up of it, the renunciation of it, the release from it, the doing away with it, this, your reverences, is called the stopping of anguish. And what, your reverences, is the course leading to the stopping of anguish? The course leading to the stopping of anguish is this ariyan eightfold way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, your reverences, the disciple of the ariyans comprehends anguish thus, comprehends its origin thus, comprehends its stopping thus, comprehends the course leading to its stopping thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the Venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the Venerable Sariputta a further question, might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the Ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, your reverences. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends old age and dying, comprehends the uprising of old age and dying, comprehends the stopping of old age and dying, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of old age and dying, to this extent also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? And what, your reverences, is old age and dying? What is the origin of old age and dying? What is the stopping of old age and dying? What is the course leading to the stopping of old age and dying? Whatever of various beings in various groups of beings is old age, decrepitude, broken teeth, graying hair, wrinkly skin, the dwindling of the life span, the collapse of the sense organs, this, your reverences, is called old age. Whatever is the falling away, the passing away, the breaking up, the disappearance, the death and dying, the action of time, the breaking up of the groups, of grasping, the laying down of the body, this, your reverences, is called dying. Thus, your reverences, this aging and this dying are called aging and dying. What is the origin of old age and dying? From the uprising of birth is the uprising of aging and dying. From the stopping of birth is the stopping of aging and dying. The course leading to the stopping of aging and dying is this Ariyan Eightfold Way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends old age and dying, thus comprehends the uprising of old age and dying, thus comprehends the stopping of old age and dying, thus comprehends the course leading to the stopping of old age and dying, thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the Venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the Venerable Sariputta a further question, might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the Ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, your reverences. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends birth, comprehends the uprising of birth, comprehends the stopping of birth, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of birth, to this extent also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? And what, your reverences, is birth? What is the uprising of birth? What is the stopping of birth? What is the course leading to the stopping of birth? Whatever is the conception, the production, the descent, the coming forth of various beings in various groups of beings, the appearance of the groups, of grasping, the acquiring of the sense bases, this, your reverences, is called birth. From the uprising of becoming is the uprising of birth. From the stopping of becoming is the stopping of birth. The course leading to the stopping of birth is this Ariyan Eightfold Way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends birth thus, comprehends the uprising of birth thus, comprehends the stopping of birth thus, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of birth thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the Venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the Venerable Sariputta a further question, might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the Ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, your reverences. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends becoming, comprehends the uprising of becoming, comprehends the stopping of becoming, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of becoming, to this extent also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? And what, your reverences, is becoming? What is the uprising of becoming? What is the stopping of becoming? What is the course leading to the stopping of becoming? Your reverences, there are these three kinds of becoming: becoming as to sense pleasures, becoming as to fine materiality, becoming as to non-materiality. From the uprising of grasping is the uprising of becoming, from the stopping of grasping is the stopping of becoming, the course leading to the stopping of becoming is this Ariyan Eightfold Way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends becoming thus, comprehends the uprising of becoming thus, comprehends the stopping of becoming thus, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of becoming thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the Venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the Venerable Sariputta a further question, might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the Ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, your reverences. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends grasping, comprehends the uprising of grasping, comprehends the stopping of grasping, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of grasping, to this extent also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? And what, your reverences, is grasping? What is the uprising of grasping? What is the stopping of grasping? What is the course leading to the stopping of grasping? There are, your reverences, these four kinds of grasping: grasping after sense pleasures, grasping after view, grasping after rites and customs, grasping after the theory of self. From the uprising of craving is the uprising of grasping, from the stopping of craving is the stopping of grasping, the course leading to the stopping of grasping is this ariyan eightfold way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends grasping thus, comprehends the uprising of grasping thus, comprehends the stopping of grasping thus, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of grasping thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the Venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the Venerable Sariputta a further question, might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the Ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, your reverences. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends craving, comprehends the uprising of craving, comprehends the stopping of craving, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of craving, to this extent also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? And what, your reverences, is craving? What is the uprising of craving? What is the stopping of craving? What is the course leading to the stopping of craving? Your reverences, there are these six kinds of craving: craving for material shapes, craving for sounds, craving for smells, craving for flavors, craving for touches, craving for mental objects. From the uprising of feeling is the uprising of craving, from the stopping of feeling is the stopping of craving, the course leading to the stopping of craving is this ariyan eightfold way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends craving thus, comprehends the uprising of craving thus, comprehends the stopping of craving thus, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of craving thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the Venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the Venerable Sariputta a further question, might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the Ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, your reverences. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends feeling, comprehends the uprising of feeling, comprehends the stopping of feeling, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of feeling, to this extent also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? And what, your reverences, is feeling? What is the uprising of feeling? What is the stopping of feeling? What is the course leading to the stopping of feeling? There are, your reverences, these six classes of feeling: feeling arising from sensory impingement on the eye, feeling arising from sensory impingement on the ear, feeling arising from sensory impingement on the nose, feeling arising from sensory impingement on the tongue, feeling arising from sensory impingement on the body, feeling arising from sensory impingement on the mind. From the uprising of sensory impingement is the uprising of feeling, from the stopping of sensory impingement is the stopping of feeling. The course leading to the stopping of feeling is this ariyan eightfold way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, your reverences, a disciple of the ariyans comprehends feeling thus, comprehends the uprising of feeling thus, comprehends the stopping of feeling thus, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of feeling thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the venerable Sariputta a further question: might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, your reverences. When, your reverences, a disciple of the ariyans comprehends sensory impingement, comprehends the uprising of sensory impingement, comprehends the stopping of sensory impingement, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of sensory impingement, to this extent also, your reverences, does a disciple of the ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. And what, your reverences, is sensory impingement? What is the uprising of sensory impingement? What is the stopping of sensory impingement? What is the course leading to the stopping of sensory impingement? Your reverences, there are these six classes of sensory impingement: sensory impingement on the eye, sensory impingement on the ear, sensory impingement on the nose, sensory impingement on the tongue, sensory impingement on the body, sensory impingement on the mind. From the uprising of the six bases of sense impressions is the uprising of sensory impingement, from the stopping of the six bases of sense impressions is the stopping of sensory impingement. The course leading to the stopping of sensory impingement is this ariyan eightfold way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, your reverences, a disciple of the ariyans comprehends sensory impingement thus, comprehends the uprising of sensory impingement thus, comprehends the stopping of sensory impingement thus, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of sensory impingement thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the venerable Sariputta a further question: might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, Your Reverences. When, Your Reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends the six bases of sense impressions, comprehends the uprising of the six bases of sense impressions. Comprehends the stopping of the six bases of sense impressions, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of the six bases of sense impressions, to this extent also, Your Reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. And what, Your Reverences, are the six bases of sense impression? What is the uprising of the six bases of sense impression? What is the stopping of the six bases of sense impression? What is the course leading to the stopping of the six bases of sense impression? Your Reverences, there are these six bases of sense impression, the basis for eye, the basis for ear, the basis for nose, the basis for tongue, the basis for body, the basis for mind. From the uprising of mind and matter is the uprising of the six bases of sense impression, from the stopping of mind and matter is the stopping of the six bases of sense impression, the course leading to the stopping of the six bases of sense impression is this Ariyan Eightfold Way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, Your Reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends the six bases of sense impression thus comprehends the uprising of the six bases of sense impression thus, comprehends the stopping of the six bases of sense impression thus, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of the six bases of sense impression thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, Your Reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. Saying, Good, Your Reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the Venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the Venerable Sariputta a further question, Might there be, Your Reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the Ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, Your Reverences. When, Your Reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends mind and matter, comprehends the uprising of mind and matter, comprehends the stopping of mind and matter, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of mind and matter, to this extent also, Your Reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? And what, Your Reverences, is mind and matter? What is the uprising of mind and matter? What is the stopping of mind and matter? What is the course leading to the stopping of mind and matter? Feeling, perception, volition, sensory impingement, reflectiveness, this, Your Reverences, is called mind. The four great elements and the material shape derived from the four great elements, this, Your Reverences, is called matter. So, Your Reverences, this that is mind and this that is matter is called mind and matter. From the uprising of consciousness is the uprising of mind and matter, from the stopping of consciousness is the stopping of mind and matter, the course leading to the stopping of mind and matter. Is this Ariyan Eightfold Way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration? When, Your Reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends mind and matter thus comprehends the uprising of mind and matter thus, comprehends the stopping of mind and matter thus, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of mind and matter thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the Venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the Venerable Sariputta a further question, might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the Ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, your reverences. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends consciousness, comprehends the uprising of consciousness, comprehends the stopping of consciousness, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of consciousness, to this extent. Also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? And what, your reverences, is consciousness? What is the uprising of consciousness? What is the stopping of consciousness? What is the course leading to the stopping of consciousness? Your reverences, there are these six classes of consciousness: visual consciousness, auditory consciousness, olfactory consciousness, gustatory consciousness, bodily consciousness, mental consciousness. From the uprising of formations is the uprising of consciousness, from the stopping of formations is the stopping of consciousness. The course leading to the stopping of consciousness is this Ariyan Eightfold Way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends consciousness thus, comprehends the uprising of consciousness thus, comprehends the stopping of consciousness thus, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of consciousness thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the Venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the Venerable Sariputta a further question, might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the Ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, your reverences. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends formations, comprehends the uprising of formations, comprehends the stopping of formations, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of formations, to this extent also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? And what, your reverences, are the formations? What is the uprising of the formations? What is the stopping of the formations? What is the course leading to the stopping of the formations? Your reverences, there are these three kinds of formations: activity of the body, activity of speech, activity of mind. From the uprising of ignorance is the uprising of the formations, from the stopping of ignorance is the stopping of the formations. The course leading to the stopping of the formations is this Ariyan Eightfold Way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends the formations, thus comprehends the uprising of the formations, thus comprehends the stopping of the formations, thus comprehends the course leading to the stopping of the formations, thus he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the venerable Sariputta a further question, might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the Ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, your reverences. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends ignorance, comprehends the uprising of ignorance, comprehends the stopping of ignorance, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of ignorance, to this extent also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? And what, your reverences, is ignorance? What is the uprising of ignorance? What is the stopping of ignorance? What is the course leading to the stopping ignorance? Whatever, your reverences, is not knowing in regard to anguish, not knowing in regard to the uprising of anguish, not knowing in regard to the stopping of anguish, not knowing in regard to the course leading to the stopping of anguish, this, your reverences, is called ignorance. From the uprising of the cankers is the uprising of ignorance, from the stopping of the cankers is the stopping of ignorance, the course leading to the stopping of ignorance is this Ariyan Eightfold Way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends ignorance, thus comprehends the uprising of ignorance, thus comprehends the stopping of ignorance, thus comprehends the course leading to the stopping of ignorance, thus he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? Saying, good, your reverence, these monks, having rejoiced in what the venerable Sariputta had said, having approved of it, asked the venerable Sariputta a further question, might there be, your reverence, also another method by which a disciple of the Ariyans comes to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who has unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? There might be, your reverences. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends the cankers, comprehends the uprising of the cankers, comprehends the stopping of the cankers, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of the cankers, to this extent also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma? And what, your reverences, is a canker? What is the uprising of a canker? What is the stopping of a canker? What is the course leading to the stopping of a canker? Your reverences, there are these three cankers, the canker of sense pleasures, the canker of becoming, the canker of ignorance. From the uprising of ignorance is the uprising of the cankers, from the stopping of ignorance is the stopping of the cankers, the course leading to the stopping of the cankers is this Ariyan Eightfold Way itself, that is to say, perfect view, perfect thought, perfect speech, perfect action, perfect way of living, perfect endeavor, perfect mindfulness, perfect concentration. When, your reverences, a disciple of the Ariyans comprehends the cankers thus, comprehends the uprising of the cankers thus, comprehends the stopping of the cankers thus, comprehends the course leading to the stopping of the cankers thus, he, having got rid of all addiction to attachment, having dispelled addiction to shunning, having abolished addiction to the latent view I am, having got rid of ignorance, having made knowledge arise, is here now an end maker of anguish. To this extent, also, your reverences, does a disciple of the Ariyans come to be of perfect view, one whose view is upright, one who is possessed of unwavering confidence in Dhamma, one who has come into this true Dhamma. Discourse on Perfect View, the 9th. And 99.